aren't you eating?
Not hungry.
We're gonna be on the road for 3 more hours. Eat.
I don't like this, Brad. Even if we run, they're gonna find us.
Hey, listen. They won't catch us if we make it to the chapel on time, so cut it out and eat your damn breakfast.
Isn't it beautiful? Found this place on my last road trip. Can you believe the owner's just up and left? We're gonna start a new life here where nobody can find us, and God will protect us, I promise.
But what if someone does find us? Someone's gonna find the bodies. What's gonna happen to us?
Only the Lord will know what we've done.
I'm worried about you, Brad. You've changed. A lot.
Don't worry about me. I'm just fine. Come on.
Hey, Brad.
Yeah.
Who owned this property before?
I have no idea.
Brad, look. What are you doing?
Stay right there.
Brad, stop.
Shut up.
What the hell is wrong with you? That man didn't deserve to die.
It's time to pay for your sins.
I've always known Bradley was a little off. To be honest, so am I. We've been in and out of foster homes together since we were 5. We really only had each other growing up. The abuse started when we were about 8 or 9. Our pastor foster dad would beat us and lock us in the barn to make us pay for our sins. And his wife started drinking a lot and she'd never help us. We planned to murder them the day Brad turned 18 so we could run away and be safe. I saw him change. He used to be so full of life, then the switch in his head just flipped. I'm sad to say I knew the day would come where he'd try to kill me too. I just didn't think it'd be today. I'm going to have to learn to live with the pain and guilt of all my sins. But I know that whatever happens to my brother, we'll see each other again, someday.
Inhale.